I went to India on holiday, and there was a bit of food going on, and there were some green chilies in a glass. Now, some green chilies are quite chewable and dippable.
And some are so not.
And the one, and I picked this one up, and I could see three Indian ladies peering around the their heads virtually nudging one another, because they'd clearly put these out as a trap. And they nibbled the very end of it, and then I was numbed on the side of my face for for several minutes.
Terrifying.
But while I was there, there was a story about an Indian woman who could eat. She set a record that's in the Guinness Book of Records or something. I mean, yeah, dozens of these things.
Yeah.
Same principle, I suppose, building up
tolerance. Yes, she did.
Have you been to Iceland?
No.
Oh, the smelly fish.
Hackerel. Oh. Have you had hackerel?
Never had it, no.
They give you this dish and it's got these little cubes of foul-smelling strong cheese on it, and you sort of take this cheese and you eat it, it's absolutely disgusting. And they go, oh. And you go, that's the worst cheese I've ever tasted. They go, it's not cheese. What is it? And hackerel is they kill a shark and then they bury it in sand on a beach so it putrefies in its own urine.
Yes.
They do. And then they dig it up and they cut it into cubes and give it to tourists.
We're supposed to feel sorry for their financial crisis.
Up yours, Bjork.
Yeah. Were they worried that tourism was going to get out of hand on that?
How bad do things have to be that putrefied urine as shark meat is your delicacy?
It's true. Gracious me. I think we should move on.